Normally, we play all our music acoustically, so it's quite strange for us to listen to ourselves being mic'd up. So it might phase us out occasionally. This next song is another older song. It's, well, not too old, it's 1969, this one. And this is a Bond theme song. And the composer is John Barry, who's famous for his kind of string arrangements of songs. But it was also used in a Guinness advert, and it's probably made famous, well, it is made famous, by Louis Armstrong. And it's all the time in the world.
No! in the waves, you know. And all I have to do is think of her. Something in the thing she shows me.
It actually is. It was written in 1989. And I think the kind of meaning behind the song is to enjoy each other's love until we die, and towards the song, the kind of sort of setting and this kind of precious thing. I think that's the point of the song.
Ease my troubles, that's what you do.
troubles, that's what you do.
We're going to get go back in time, I guess. This is a song that was written by a guy that was born in the last century, and he was 33 years old when he wrote this song, in 1926. And he was writing for a Rodgers and Hart musical. And he's Russian-born, and he's responsible for a lot of very well-known musical songs. And things that... There's No Business Like Show Business, he wrote, and he wrote And You Get Your Gun, which I always get confused with Clarity Jane. I'm sure it's because, and I've actually checked this, but Howard Keel played the leading role in... No, I've checked. We had him on the chat last night when we were practicing, but he was in, and that's why I get confused. Because in fact, Calamity Jane is my mum's favourite music. I think it is. I think she was a bit of a tomboy, actually, so she fancied herself as a bit of a Calamity Jane. She's certainly a Calamity Jane. John Barry earlier on in the evening, didn't we, sometime? I did. And it was about All the Time in the World. This is Midnight Cowboy, and he actually wrote the theme song to Midnight Cowboy, so it's another film thing. But in fact, the song that we all remember from Midnight Cowboy probably isn't the John Barry theme, but the John Barry theme is a lovely song, so it's got a great harmonica in it. So we haven't really done this deliberately, but we've kind of ended up with an arrangement of this other song, which is called Everybody's Talking, that Fred Neil did. And we've got a harmonica that kind of plays through it, that kind of gives the kind of same kind of vibe to the whole film. It's a terribly sad film, Dustin Hoffman dying on the coach. It's all about escaping the horrible place he was in New York. But they were both escaping the horrible place they were in. I thought this for a reason. They were escaping to Florida. So this was the kind of tune that was playing as they were escaping their horrible lives in New York.
Sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Well, ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away, I wonder this time where she's gone. I wonder where she's gonna stay. Well, ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And this house just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away.
That wasn't actually her first film. Her first film was actually called Girls Come First. You might guess what kind of a film it was. But she was one of those kind of tearaway kids. She ran away from home at 16 and she went recording records. And she's still going around. She's acting and singing and recording. But she's probably most famous for this song. It's very famous. It's very famous because of the
your coffee while I sip my tea. so cool, thinking what will be, will be. But it's getting kind of late now. I wonder if you'll stay now, stay now, stay now, stay now. Or would you just politely say goodnight?
Well, is it something you've been waiting for? Waiting for two.
Two falling apart, apparently. Apparently they were going to go their separate ways. I think Bono and The Edge were into dance music at the time. It's probably just before that Zoo album. And they were drifting apart, the two people, the two sets of two, really, kind of the rhythm section and the kind of guitar and singer. But this song's often sung as a kind of the first dance of a wedding, that kind of thing, because it's warm. The song's called Warm. And I guess people think it's all about people coming together. But the words aren't actually about that, so it's often kind of misinterpreted, because it's actually about the fact that people who don't get on have to get on. So it's about a love that brings people together because of their differences, really. so not really appropriate for a wedding. Maybe highly appropriate for a wedding.
I want to cry and empty the I know we do.
very special. I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong here.
Terry actually is the only pop star I know. I was reading The Guardian one day, and you know the kind of 10 things you must listen to? It mentioned the band that Terry was in, it's called Girls at Our Best, and it was a band that was around the 80s? And so Terry's done the whole kind of drugs, rock and roll thing. Obviously with Karen, it's taken its toll on Karen. There was another thing actually. Oh, the other really cool thing that we happened to Terry. We had a party one time and everyone had to choose three songs to dance to. It's a good thing for a party. So everybody chose three songs, but somebody chose a song by the birthday party that was in fact written by Terry, who was at the party. How cool is that? This is a Talking Heads song. Terry and I, we were keen on doing this, we were in a slightly bigger band, but everybody else said, you can't do this, it's by a psychopath. And the song's called Psycho Killer. David Byrne was trying to do was get in the head of a psychopath. So, bear that in mind as I blurt out the words. And what this psychopath is all about, he's obviously some kind of misogynist, because there's a bit where he starts talking about people not shutting up, and I know you ladies sometimes aren't prone to not shutting up. And there's a bit, he goes into French. Have I said the wrong thing? He goes into French, and I think it's because he's got such a big opinion of himself. He thinks in French, you see, and it's all about what he does to some woman who's talking too much some night. Yeah, it's a word of warning.
Well, don't touch me, I'm a real live wire.
Something to him. He was chasing girls and he said, "You're like a dog chasing a car." He's like, "When you get it, you're not going to know what you're going to do with it." So this is apparently the inspiration behind this song.
Show me a garden that's bursting into life.
forget the world.
Now, I can't remember all this, to be honest, but apparently she appeared in Hard Day's Night, and she became the wife of George Harrison for a while. And apparently the song Something that we played earlier on, she thought was about her, but later George Harrison denied that it was about her, so But then, later on, Eric Clapton, who fell in love with Patty Boyd, actually went out with Patty Boyd's sister, who was 17 years old at the time, apparently. They're only solid. And eventually went out with her sister as well, because the song Layla from Derek and the Dominoes, is that, I'm picking up little bits about it, but Layla was about the loving the sister, but wanting to love the older sister. It was high on drugs at the time. You probably didn't know what it was doing. And apparently everybody fell in love with Patty Boyd. So I think John Lennon had a crush on her, and Mick Jagger had a crush on her. But there you go. She must be some locker.
She a bit like Amy Winehouse.
I don't know. Fix on your phone.
before I wanted to get ready for a night. So, and that's how the song starts. It's slightly irritable, isn't it? But it actually turns, as we men always do, we mellow after parties, a few beers, that kind of thing. And it's a proper, you look wonderful tonight, rather than you look wonderful tonight. Moving swiftly on.
Well, all I've got's this.
have a mixed guitar room.
Okay, I've got a few thank yous to say because this is our last song. First of all, I want to thank Ladbroke Vince. I thank Terry. I'd like to thank Adam, who's done all the sound tonight, and for us it's well worth it. I'd like to thank Alan Penny from Seven, and they've been a big help in getting things set up. So. I'd like to thank Katie for making all the effort to get here. I'd like to thank Karen, Jackie, and Leela as well, they're our partners. They put up with us practicing for twice a week now for the last 4 or 5 weeks or so. So it's quite a lot to live with in your house. Big thank you for the up and coming stars, Joe and Josh. Thank you. And I would like to say thank you to Sarah. And I'd like to say thank you to Mum and everybody. I know lots of people, all my aunties and uncles and people, everybody who brought stuff for the raffle, because I think everybody's gone up. I can't fucking believe it. How rude. I was doing Richard Griffin. So,
Thanks to Stuart for doing the raffle and everything, and everybody who provided the raffle prizes. I think that's about it.
Right.
I think
that's it. This was written by a fella called Lead Belly, and it's an American. It's not about you, Cameron. he was an early black kind of. He was actually, apparently, this is according to Dick, I'm not sure if it's true,
it's
apparently.
Absolutely true.
This song was so good, he was in prison, he'd killed somebody in a bar brawl or something like that, and this song was so good that the.
Actually partly released it, he was released onto the world to make the song even more popular.
So, it's a well good song. You'll all know it, and you might want to sing along. Sorry.
Married, got married. Me and my
didn't like it, and he rewrote the lyrics into a song about losing your virginity. To go home to.